Hi everyone, and welcome to the Mapathon event organized by Open Summer of Code and with support of Open Knowledge Belgium, Brussels Mobility, and Bike for Brussels. My name is Thibaut, and I am a member of the Cyclofix team during this year's Open Summer of Code, or OSOC. Now, OSOC, for those of you who don't know it yet, is a four-week program where different open source projects are developed by students, coaches, and organizations. Now, the goal of this of my team, the Cyclofix team, is to map, present, and integrate all relevant cycling infrastructure and points of interest for cyclists in the Brussels region. And as a result, cyclists will be able to quickly find the nearest pump or parking or bike repair station when needed. That is our ultimate goal. We have seen that a lot of this data is already there, but it is scattered all over the place or difficult to consult, and we want to centralize all of it, actually. Now, in order to reach that goal, today's Mapathon is being organized to collect as much data as possible. First of all, we would like to thank you very much for signing up and helping us with this open source project. But before you can get started, I will give you a short tutorial on what is expected from you during today's event. So the goal is to map as many bicycle pumps, parkings, bike shops, repair stations, even public places where you can get drinking water as possible. And to do that, you can use a mapping tool, which my team has developed the past few weeks. You can find a link to the tool in the email we sent you last night or in the description below. Now, what is important about this Mapathon is that all the data you enter will be saved in OpenStreetMap, which is basically the Wikipedia of maps. If you don't have an account already, please make one, because you will need it to grant the Mapathon tool access to your account in order to start using it. Now, let us have a look about the tool itself over here. First, you have to log in. I'm already logged in here. There is a short introduction, and then you have the map itself. When you start mapping, you will have two options. You can either click on a blank space to add new points of interest you encounter, or you can click on an existing icon and add more data by answering all the questions. Now, you'll be editing in a live database, which means that all data provided will flow to other apps and GPS devices automatically. And the cool thing about that is that you will be able to see your results immediately. Now let's have a look at the mapping tool. For example, here we are in the neighborhood of the VUB in Brussels. You see there are a lot of public parking spaces, a lot of bike shops, some pumps in the neighborhood, and a few places where you can get tap water. So if you are cycling, for example, in the street here, or you find a bike shop that isn't mapped yet, or a repair station that isn't mapped yet, you can simply click on the map, zoom in a bit more, yes, and then you can here click to add, for example, a bike station, and it will automatically appear as a pin. If you click on the pin, you can add a picture, and you can add answer a few questions, for example, which services are available in this bike station. And if you see there's only a pump available, you click there's only a pump, and you can save it. Who operates the bike station? If you don't know the answer, you can skip the question. Is the bike pump manual or electric? Let's say manual, for example. Does it have a pressure indicator or a manometer? If it doesn't, it doesn't. What valves are supported? Only Dunlop, only for a car. The default bike valves, for example, and so on. You can also add a picture, and you can answer as many questions as you like. Now, if you For example, pass by the pump over here in this street. You can simply click on it, and if you see that the data is not complete, for example, there's a picture missing, or the questions are answered wrongly, you can also edit this over here. So that's basically it. You can either add a new point of interest by clicking on the map or clicking on all the icons to edit the data in the database. So the last thing I would like to say is that you can also join our Strava club in the link below. So it would be really cool if we can monitor all the activity about people who have been cycling around Brussels today. Now, many of you will probably be on the road and map everything they encounter using their smartphone. If not, we will certainly welcome you at the B Central, which will be our meeting point for today. We have foreseen to end the mapping at about 5 o'clock and we'll close off with a beer, of course. It's our national holiday. So feel free to pass by, have a drink and get in touch with our project and the community about OpenStreetMap. So that's about it. So the last thing I would like to say is get out there, try to map as much as possible, and don't forget to have a little bit fun. Thank you.